that there's millions of Americans who could soon be without broadband.
I think that's an awfully broad statement. I mean, you know, I think really part of that is coming from the fact that people have to choose now based on being unemployed of what do I pay for? Do I pay for my cell phone? Do I pay for my rent? Do I pay for my utilities? And let me just basically just stop paying my cell phone bill or my internet bill because I can't afford it. And it's crazy that people have to make that kind of decision. I think everyone on this call would agree that it is a utility. Everyone needs that. You can't realistically find a job without a cell phone. I mean, right. You do job searches on a cell phone. You have to give a number to a prospective employer. The idea that somehow you can operate in today's world without one is completely crazy.
Yeah.
What gets a little frustrating, if I may, is that, you know, at the federal level, it gets very frustrating because most of the focus tends to be on, let's focus on rural broadband. And, you know, what does that mean? That means, well, that happens in my house, too. What is that? You know, what happens with all the focus on rural broadband, which is a noble effort, is that you have to, you know, lay fiber and do very expensive build-outs to provide that service to many of these people who are in the middle of nowhere. And for a company and a business person, the economics don't make sense. So the government has to get involved to provide that program. And the problem is, if all our focus is on that, rather than something like this, which is an immediate solution, and I mean, candidly, it's not a total solution for people who are living in the middle of Oklahoma, you know, 100 miles from a large city. However, it's enough of a solution right now with all the issues we're contending with that the focus of funding in Washington should be how do we take the Lifeline program, increase money into the program to get more people covered. The worst case is people in rural areas can take this hotspot of this phone and go to a place where there is a connection, whether it's, and that's the Wi-Fi technology we've built into this. So you can take this to a Starbucks, take it to a, you know, Walmart, take it to wherever, and you can access the internet that way. And it's not perfect, but it's a much better solution than we've got now.
That's good. Well, Matthew, thank you for joining us today. I think we've run out of time.
Okay.
And the information that you've provided is going to be so helpful to everyone.
Yeah. Because I really think that this, what you're talking about, is a basic human right at this point.
Yeah.
You got to have access to, otherwise you're so disconnected from society that it's just one more wall, one more hurdle that you have to climb.
No, it really is, and it's certainly in the last 10 years. I mean, it's become more and more just a necessity. You cannot live without that communication service.
Right. Hey, thanks again.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate the time, guys.
All right, our pleasure.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, it's about time to wrap it up and say our goodbyes until next Saturday. If you've missed any part of our show and you'd like to hear our previous shows, go to YouTube or Brothers in Law or iTunes. If you have a legal question or a show topic, call us and leave a message at 1-800-310-7113. That's 1-800-310-7113.
Mm-hmm. Please do call us. And a big thank you to everyone out there who's listening to our show. We don't do this show for profit. This is our way of giving back to the community by highlighting great folks in the community like Nathan. And it's just something we need to do, right, Laura? Yes, we do. And we look forward to being here next week with all of you on Saturday at 8 a.m. right here on Go Country 105. And remember, let the scales of justice tip in your favor.
The opinions expressed in the Brothers in Law Show are for informational purposes only and are not a substitute for personal professional legal advice.
The preceding recorded program is a paid advertisement by Brothers in Law. We offer this program as a service to our listeners. This station and its management do not endorse or object to the information, views, or opinions discussed in the program.
Go Country 105.
the crash.
Into the water, we were feeling all right. Back down the country road, the girls are always hot and the beer is ice cold. Cadillac, horns on the hood. My buddy Frankie had his dad hook him up good. Girls smile when we roll by, they hop in the back and we cruise to the riverside. Whoa.